There is no ifs, ands, or buts on that. Roleplays without activity checks are doomed to die a slow death as people become distracted with shinier, newer things.
Spare Room with Karen Terry.
Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about activity rules for your roleplay group. In my top 10 rules for your RP group video, I talked about how for number 3, you needed to have some kind of activity guidelines in your rules. Activity requirements are going to vary based on the type of roleplay that you're running, as well as the pace that you expect for your roleplay, but those activity requirements should be described in your rules. Like activity expectations, your rules should highlight hiatus expectations as well. You want players to be able to take a hiatus because what you don't want is for players to think like, oh gosh, if I take a little break, that means everything I've done in the roleplay is for naught. It's all lost and I can't come back. I'm going to link that video up in the card and I do recommend watching it, but for this video, essentially what we're going to do is do a deep dive on those activity and those hiatus rules so that you know how to set up your activity rules and your hiatus rules so that your players stay active in your roleplay. And I'm going to try to make this as platform agnostic as possible, so understand also you're going to probably need to make adjustments on my advice based on what platform your roleplay is hosted on. Alright, so what I've put up here on screen right now are the activity and the hiatus rules for my roleplay, and this is what we're going to use as our basis for our deep dive. So let's take a look through them. So the first one is activity. This is a long-term RP, so while you aren't expected to reply immediately, you are expected to do so in a timely manner to move the story along. Number 2, activity checks. After 7 days of inactivity, you will be activity checked and you have 24 hours to reply. Hiatus. If you're going to be gone for more than a week, please request a hiatus from the mods. Hiatus are granted at the mod's discretion. And then number 4, inactivity. Recurrent inactivity may cause you to get removed from the roleplay. So notice first that this is very short and simple. There are only 4 rules here, only 85 words total to read. And this is my first point. Don't make your activity rules too hard or too complicated. If it's too complicated to stay active in your roleplay, then no one is gonna do it. They're gonna look at that and they're gonna say, I can't meet those activity requirements. Those are complicated. I don't even understand what they mean. If you do that, basically you're gonna lose people from your roleplay immediately. They're gonna join, they're gonna be just barely active, and then they're gonna bail. So your activity rules should only cover exactly what they need to cover, and no more. Alright, so let's now break down each rule. Rule number 1 is activity, and it reads, this is a long-term RP, so while you aren't expected to reply immediately, you are expected to do so in a timely manner to move the story along. This first rule exists to set expectations, so for people that are just joining the roleplay, they know what to expect for activity in this roleplay. So think for your roleplay, what do you actually expect people to do? And I don't mean what is against the rules versus what isn't against the rules. I mean, what behavior do you actually want them displaying in the roleplay as far as activity goes? Should players be replying to their threads rapid fire, daily, weekly? What exactly are you expecting for their reply speed? What is normal for your roleplay? You need to tell them that. I do this by saying, while you aren't expected to reply immediately, you are expected to do so in a timely manner. You also need to explain why. For example, if your expectation is rapid fire, someone with school or a job likely can't keep up with that. They're going to need to take breaks to go handle their responsibilities. So you need to tell them why you expect rapid fire. On the flip side, if you expect replies to be slower than that, a lot of players might be bored by that style of roleplay. So you need to tell them why. I do this by saying, this is a long-term RP, and also the statement that says to move the story along. I am running narrative roleplays where story is king, so my activity rules support this type of roleplay. Rule number 2 is activity checks, and it reads, after 7 days of inactivity, you will be activity checked and have 24 hours to reply. A little aside to explain what an activity check is before we get into the rule itself. An activity check is posting publicly that some player or some character must post in character within a certain amount of time or risk some kind of consequence. That consequence may be anything from a formal warning to losing a character to being removed from the roleplay entirely. If you want people to stay active in your roleplay, you have to have activity checks. There is no ifs, ands, or buts on that. Roleplays without activity checks are doomed to die a slow death as people become distracted with shinier, newer things. Alright, so now that we've established what an activity check is, let's break the rule down. So after I set expectations in Rule 1, I'm explaining in Rule 2 exactly where the line is on that expectation. And your activity rules must also do this. Because the expectation is this is a long-term narrative roleplay, it should not be shocking to see that the amount of time you're allowed to disappear is 7 days, and at that point there's going to be some kind of warning or consequence. My roleplays typically consist of college students, working adults, parents with young kids, people like that, and they will typically post about a one-paragraph response, kind of as their day goes on and they're handling their responsibilities. So this fits for my roleplay, but if your roleplay skews younger or less experienced, or maybe there's lots of one-liners or people that have lots of free time, then you're going to need more stringent activity rules. Maybe consider a 3-day limit or a 5-day limit instead of a 7-day limit. And then on the flip side, if your roleplay skews older, more experienced, or maybe like long novella style, then you probably need looser activity requirements than what I have. Consider 2 weeks, or maybe even a month in some cases. Once a person or a character, in the case of how we run our RPs, is activity checked, they have 24 hours to go post as that character in a reply to make sure that they get activity back where it should be. You'll need to make sure that your activity check has a time frame in it as well. So let me show you what one of mine looks like. Here's a screenshot right here. And you can see it says, after 7 days of inactivity, you will be activity checked and have 24 hours to reply. The following characters must write an in-character post within the next 24 hours. And then it lists the characters and it tags the particular person. So make sure when you post your activity checks that you restate your activity rule. The chances that someone remembers your exact activity role from when they joined your roleplay months and months ago is basically zero, so you have to remind them. Alright, so that is rule number 2. Next, let's move on to rule number 3. This is the hiatus rule. If you're going to be gone for more than a week, please request a hiatus from the mods. Hiatuses are granted at the mod's discretion. This is my hiatus rule, again, short and sweet. And this flows from the activity check rule. Since activity checks are every 7 days, we only need to know for a hiatus if you're going to disappear for a week or more. If it's shorter than that, frankly, I don't care, you don't need to tell me. And the next bit is hiatuses are granted at mod's discretion. This is because depending on exactly what's going on, what the situation is, it's possible that the hiatus request is none of anyone else's business. I don't want players to feel forced to explain to the entire RP what's going on in their life that makes them need a hiatus. They are not beholden to everyone in the RP as far as what is okay for a hiatus and what is not. This is also because I rarely tell people they're not allowed to have a hiatus. Most of the time, it's totally fine. And of course, the longer that you've been in the roleplay and the more active that you have been while you were present, the more lenient we're going to be when it comes to hiatus. And this means most of our hiatus rules aren't codified, and your rules should only cover 80% of the situations anyway. They shouldn't cover 100%. You don't want to have like a huge ginormous laundry list of activity rules. No one wants to read that, no one cares. So what hiatus things are discretion for us? First, we don't grant hiatuses for lost muse or lost inspiration. This just means you're not interested in the roleplay anymore, and if you're not interested, you don't get a hiatus. You can leave. Now, this may sound harsh at first, but let's break it down. Let's think about why people ask for a hiatus for lost inspiration. The reason they do this is they think because if they leave, then they have lost everything that they've built up in that roleplay. But that does not have to be the case. So what we do is if someone loses inspiration, if they leave the roleplay, and then later on they decide they want to come back, they've got inspiration again and they're excited to roleplay again, okay, they can just come back. They don't have to do a whole new application. We save our past applications so they can say, hey, I'm back, I'm good again, can I pick up my character, whatever their name is? We have all the information they originally submitted, they get to rejoin, they're good to go. If you implement this, then you can dissuade the fears of leaving that people are feeling when they ask for these hiatuses. Second, we do not grant a hiatus for longer than a month. Again, story is king in our roleplay, and if you take a break of longer than a month, it really interrupts the flow of that story. It makes it so that your character ends up not being able to participate in a bunch of things that maybe naturally they would participate in. It might slow up other people who have certain ties between their character and your character, so a month is the maximum hiatus that you can take. But sometimes there are extenuating circumstances, so I'm not going to write in the rules that you only get a month hiatus, because maybe there's a situation where they need a month and a week, and it's a very particular situation, maybe very sensitive, and we're going to say yes that time. We don't know until we know exactly what's going on with that player. And I would recommend that you guys do the same when it comes to your hiatus rules. Only codify what is always going to be true. Only codify the 80% situations. Don't worry about codifying those one-off situations. You don't have to be that specific. You can talk to each player when they request a hiatus. All right, next one is rule number 4, inactivity. Recurrent inactivity may cause you to get removed from the roleplay. This is the final rule in the activity rules of the roleplay. If you are constantly being activity checked, if you are constantly requesting hiatus, if you are constantly just not really around, then we're going to remove you from the roleplay. Nothing kills a roleplay faster than having a ton of dead accounts just sitting there, not doing anything, not really roleplaying. So if that's you, we're going to remove you from the roleplay. Now, as we talked about in the leadership skills video, remember, these rules have to be followed by you and your mods. If you guys do not follow these rules, your players will not follow these rules. You and your mods need to make sure that you can keep up with your own rules and your own pace that you set before you expect players to do so. So really think about what is important also to you guys and what's possible for you before you decide exactly what to codify in your activity rules. So to recap, 4 rules up on the screen again. We've got our activity rule that sets expectations. We've got our activity check rule, which tells you exactly what's going to happen and when. We've got our hiatus rule that explains the basis of what we expect when it comes to hiatus. And we've got our inactivity rule to kind of seal it all up and let people know that they are going to be removed if they don't follow the activity rules. And I recommend that your activity rules cover these same 4 areas as well. So think about your particular roleplay and your particular situation and your particular platform and how you can apply those 4 things to your roleplay and write those up as your activity rules. So this was my deep dive into activity rules. Do you guys do it this way? Do you guys do something different? I'm really curious about how you guys handle activity in your roleplays. Let me know down below. And don't forget to make it a great day.